Oh yeah, that is Matthew McConaughey.
The big lump with knobs, it has the juice.
It is, hold up, got Mimi on the ring.
Hey!
This isn't, I'm not going
into
Mexico.
Yes, you are.
Oh, I can't see with these on. So, I've been driving through Texas and it's gorgeous. It's like 80 degrees, perfect. Like I got the window down, I'm vibing, listening to lo-fi, you know. And I came up on these signs that said Uvalde. Uvalde, is that how you say it? And I was like, why does that sound so familiar to me? And the GPS just told me to turn right to Uvalde. And I was like, what is that? At first I thought it was Gavin Newsom. But then I realized, no, that's someone else entirely. Can you see it? Hold on, I'm gonna get my flashlight. I finally get to use my flashlight. Hold on. I'm literally right off of the highway, so it's a little dangerous. And it's nighttime, but whatever, we're fine. We're fine. Look at this shit. Oh, it's Matthew McConaughey. All right, all right, all right. Oh, I love living on the road. This was a great 1 month anniversary and we're not even done. It's perfect weather. Oh my God. You remember this morning when it was all gloomy and gray and I was all sad and about to cry? And now we're here at the birthplace of Matthew McConaughey. What a blessing. Lock your doors. All right, let's keep it going. We still got about an hour until we get to Planet Fitness. So I'll check back in then. Can you guys see that? Oh yeah, that is Matthew McConaughey. The birthplace of. All right, all right, all right. Oh my gosh. All right, we've made it. I'm not sure what town we're in. Did I say military something? I don't know, but my God, this has been one of the most pleasant drives. I needed a nice drive like this. It's just 80 degrees, nighttime. The roads are fairly straight and smooth. There's not hardly any traffic out. Ooh, ooh. And just playing, I don't know what that was, I'm sorry. And playing lo-fi and just vibing. It's just gorgeous. I guess you could say it's all right, all right, all right. I'm in a really good mood. So yeah, we got here with plenty of time. It's 10 after 9. They don't close till 10. So we're just gonna run in there. All these people are making out. Don't look at them. So we're just gonna go in there, get a shower, get a quick little massage, as I mentioned before. And then we'll figure out where we're spending the night. We might drive a little farther down. I think we still got like 2, maybe 3 hours before Big Bend. But Big Bend. We're not going to London today. I don't know how we're gonna get Buffy there, but. You hear that? That's probably how I lost my solar panel. Well, one of the ways. There we go. All right, let me go scrub-a-dub-dub. I'll be back in a minute. All right, we're actually in Del Rio. I did not know that. We are like right on the border. I kept thinking I saw Border Patrol. Definitely never been this close to it before. But I was in there in the massage chair doing a little research, trying to find a place to camp for the night. I want to drive a little bit farther. Ironically enough, I was like, I want to drive at least 1 more hour. I'm in the mood. And I found a place 57 minutes away on the Del Rio, the Rio Grande. Yeah. Yeah. Big river that separates the countries. So let's go. So I'm in the middle of nowhere. We're like basically in Mexico. And it is pitch black all around me, like here. And the sky, I wish the GoPro could pick up how beautiful the stars look tonight. But I literally had to stop a minute ago. Why is this so loud? much fun. Oh, it's kind of scary, but I like that. But yeah, let me show you how dark it is.
Yes, you are. I didn't realize that. You don't know how to turn around.
Yeah, yeah, no, I was like, I was coming up here. Hello. Don't mess with me. I was like, this can't be right, because I was just trying to get to... Okay. I've never been this far south. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm from North Carolina. I'm confused as hell. Do y'all need... I'm going to Big Bend.
Big Bend.
And then Fort Stockton after that. Do y'all need some ID or anything?
All
right, cool. Well,
thank you.
Thanks for... Oh, I know. I already saw a couple. I'll be careful. Right.
Care.
Bye, guys. Have a good night. Oh, fuck. Oh, my God. Holy shit. They scared the shit out of me, man. All right. Okay, we made it finally to a campsite. The first place I put in, it was gated. There was like two entrances. They both were gated. I couldn't get in. So I ended up driving to drive an extra... My hair is crazy. What is happening? I ended up having to drive an extra, like, probably 45 minutes altogether. But I'm at a picnic site. You can't see. I'll show you in the morning. But there's a bunch of semis right here and another camper van back there. It's just a pull-off area. There's nothing. I think there's maybe some trash cans, hopefully. But yeah, this is fine. We're on a little bit of a slant, but I don't even care. I can sleep like this. It's totally fine. I had to pull out the Wii Boost. I don't know if you can see, because we were in the middle of nowhere and I had no signal, and that was an interesting thing to experience. That was definitely a van life staple. Yeah, but the Wii Boost, it gave me just enough to find this place. Hey, good morning.
Oh, man.
Oh, it's after 9. I slept so hard. It was so quiet here. I'm so curious to see what it looks like. I think it looks really cool. Let's find out together. I haven't even looked yet. Oh, wow. We're in the middle of nowhere. How do I look? God, I slept so hard. I needed it. It was just silent. That was so nice. Let's go look outside. I want to see. Oh. Ooh. Yeah. I needed that.
Holy crap.
Oh my God, everybody's gone. it was so many. Well, I mean, it was probably like, I don't even know how many trucks, probably like 8, maybe 10, and one van. They're all gone. This is cool though. So we got my mess of a Wii Boost up here. That thing came in real handy, but it is such a tangled mess. I'm so terrible with cords and stuff like that. Wow, I got this whole place to myself. Dang. See, I tried to park right up there last night, kind of be away from that other van. There's a canyon over there. Oh my God. I didn't even... What? oh, I think this next leg of this journey is gonna be something real special. I don't know what that is, but I'm excited to find out. I haven't even fixed my hair. I'm just so excited. And I feel like what I just said, like the future of me being on the west side of the country, which I'm so excited to finally be here. I understand that it's just a lot of this. And it reminds me of, I think I might have mentioned it before. Forgive me if I have, but when I went to the Mojave Desert, I was with my bestest buddy, or one, don't tell Lana, but Tyrell. We went to high school together. We went to Vegas multiple times back in the day, and we decided to rent a car and drive from Vegas to Los Angeles, because neither of us had ever been to Los Angeles. And if you've ever made that drive from Vegas to LA, or just through the Mojave Desert, you know, it's kind of like driving through Kansas. At the beginning, it's like, oh, let me tell you, I cannot see the screen with these on. It like hurts my eyes. But yeah, like in the beginning, it's like, oh, this is, I remember we both were like taking pictures left and right. Oh, this is gorgeous, much like I am right now. It's like, oh, this is amazing. This is so beautiful. It's like I'm in a calendar. It's like a Windows 98 screensaver. It's so great. And then like 3, 4, or 5 hours pass, and it's like, I hate this place. It's the same shit. I saw an oasis in the Mojave Desert. That's how it just is forever. That motherfucker big. They're real big. But let's go look at this canyon. You see it? What the? I never seen something like that before in real life anyway. Look at that. Some thicker shorts. let's get this day going. Tell me that don't look good. Tell me that don't look good. Nice. With a view too. Don't mind if I do. I know that was a sloppy way of cooking this, but you gotta agree. It looks pretty good. Why is my hair? Why is it? Whatever. Yum. Okay, so I looked up like campsites at Big Bend. I was hoping I can get one that had like an electric hookup, but that ain't happening. Apparently this is busy season, which makes sense. It's March, it's not stupid hot. I bet it's crazy in the summer here. So we're just gonna go. We're just gonna go to Big Bend, we're gonna explore. If anything, we might get a campsite outside of it. Or we'll just stealth camp, because I actually took, hold on, can you see it? I actually took this guy, because it was still fully charged. I charged it the whole way. I didn't get it, it's fine. I charged it the whole way here. We drove like 3 hours, probably more than that last night, so it was completely charged. So I just went ahead and hooked it up to the Blue Eddy, because the Blue Eddy was low. And it sucked this is 600 watt. It sucked every last bit of that out within 20 minutes. But now I got 2 bars instead of one, so that makes me 2 bars is like the minimum that I can be somewhat comfortable. 1 bar, we're gonna lose power, you know. So now we got this guy charging again. It's a 2-hour drive. This takes about 2 hours to completely drive, so or completely fill up. So we should be good. And this is what I use primarily. I don't know if you've noticed, like for TV and anything like that. And I've been charging my devices with this too. This was a good purchase. This was only $100. It's not a Jackery, it's an off-brand one, but it's been pretty great. I've had it for over a year now and I've used the hell out of it. But yeah, we're gonna go to Big Bend. Have fun.
And there's a place right next to it. I can't remember the name of it. But we're going to go there too if we have time. I think we're going to be down here for at least 2 or 3 days. So we don't have to rush. Oh yeah. I feel my energy levels rising. We're going to have a good day. We're going to have a good day. I'm so excited. Let me finish my breakfast. And then we'll hit the road. If I remember correctly, I think it's 2 hours away. Probably a little bit more. I'm gonna be a fantasy. You ain't gonna believe this. Hold up. Got Mimi on the ring. Hey.
For this drive, it was so dark last night I couldn't see anything, and oh my god, I'm already loving it. Yeah,
well, we didn't make it too far. Literally that's where we spent the night, but I drove past this and I was like, yeah, let's check it out. There, we're gonna, like, the future of this vlog, there are so many abandoned spots we're gonna go check out. I'm all about some abandoned stuff, some haunted stuff. What is it? I love corn. It's a big lump with knobs. It has the juice. That's good. And I know what you're thinking. That's Wendy. Now you see that monkey? That's Pippi Longstocking. If you don't know who Pippi Longstocking is, I feel bad for you, son. That old bed. Peace. Whoa. Wow. Don't I take you nice places? Born to be Wild, 1968. Tony Mays? The Tony Mays? Oh my God, Rob Freeze. Get out of here. Oh no, someone lost their panties. Go check out this other one over here real quick and then we'll hit the road. We'll make it to Big Bend. I know we will. Yeah, I'm gonna go out the other way. I don't wanna walk through the brush. I have delicious toes. I do. I know that's a weird thing to say, but. I think there may be some structural damage. I'm no contractor, but maybe a smidge. Cabins. So I wonder, I think this might have been a motel, maybe. Huh. Yeah, a little motel. I'm not gonna go in there. I like the arch though, that's pretty cool. I'm so impressed with everything, aren't I? Oh, that's interesting. Look at the yellow floor, or what's left of it. I know I said I wasn't gonna go in, but you know what?
I'm a crazy girl. Was this the floor? No sé. All right. I'm not gonna say go to Big Bend. Let's head towards Big Bend. I have a feeling we're gonna have a lot of stops along the way. But you know what? It's the beauty of this life that I'm living. I'm in no hurry. Oh yeah, speaking of, I do have something scheduled. Oh my gosh, check this out. Home sweet home. Lana bought her plane tickets this morning, so she's gonna come meet me. Well, I'm gonna pick her up in Albuquerque. April 9th, my birthday. We're gonna pick her up in Albuquerque, and we're gonna drive up to Taos and goose it out, baby. I'm hoping some other friends can come, but she's the only one I know for sure is coming. And of course you guys, you'll be there, right? So that's exciting. Onward back.